Chua-senpai, we are back for Cat Quest. Watch this weird guy get executed for some reason.
Another gutter rat.
Silence, criminal. You die as you lived.
Interesting. Yeah, we have to do a bit of it because my previous save got all weird. Oh, and... dead. Arnold.
I can't stay here.
Leonard. Huh, nothing. It's a rat.
Something you need? May the reach show mercy.
Madeline, town ruler.
All right then.
Oh wait, this is the way here, to the thing. That's up to that shrine, the Shrine of Mara thing that I left off in the last episode. Time to whirlwind. Hang on. I don't need your petty roads, peasants. Little road peasants. I can just like zap over and talk to these boys.
Get on with it.
Hello.
Jackoffs. You don't need me to tell you that. Just look around. It seems as though the gods are trying to wash away this city as well as all the other omens.
I hear this is the Lord.
No idea you can get your tongue cut off for having your words strike so close to treason. But I shouldn't fault you. You just speak of what your eyes first come to see. The truth is, the Lord is laying spite on anyone he deems wrong.
Huh.
The people within these walls used to have pride and community. Now apathy and tension permeate the air. Some have taken their own lives.
Oh, geez, it's gotten bad up here.
Evermore, tell them we need help. If it's not the Lord that will be our undoing, it's the countless other evils lurking near.
Hang on, guys, I have to do something.
Keep safe.
See you guys in a minute. Alright, so we need to deliver this news back to Marosa. But also hand that gold and something that beggar was telling us about. Yeah, see, I was just going to have dinner, and see, my dad's friend, Danny, actually was able to catch some Atlantic striper from Cape Cod. And we're... That's what we ate. I'm Mr. Rangfarm recently suffered a flood which had devastated produce and stone alike. Various forces had seen this disaster as an opportunity to descend upon the town. Oh, that weirdly placed helmet. A strange claw begins the rite of her same hidden quest that unlocks three weak abilities. Recording just because I need to go get something. Yeah, I just have to grab something. So, yeah, we need to go and give this to. What? Ha! Back in Arnima. Pretty swifty little tower. Yeah, it's a. Pretty good stuff. Tastes like... this is the first time me and my dad have had Atlantic Striper, and to me it tastes like grilled chicken. That's like the texture and taste. Tastes like grilled chicken. Like, you know how like chicken tastes different? Like fried chicken, roast chicken, baked chicken, grilled chicken. Like grilled chicken definitely tastes a lot more hearty. If you could say it like that. Fried chicken, lot very tender and stuff. Same case with stuff something like I don't know, popcorn chicken or chicken McNuggets.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm just a little confused since this Arnima place is huge. See? And it's all, and there's just alleys of things and huge open spaces. It's a little overwhelming, actually. So we gotta go deliver this gold. I said... Oh wait, never mind. I don't think we'll be able to make our way back past. Yeah, I think they made that area inaccessible, like you can't jump past it, I guess. Oh, that's pretty cool. Custom Swifty asset. This. Cool. Increases my two-handed skill. Set.
Step aside.
Man, you're tall. How'd you get your armor?
Tooth fairy. Crushed a couple of orc skulls and put all their teeth under my pillow. When I woke up, there it was. You should
see it. It's pretty funny, actually. Why are you so tall?
You so ugly.
Oh man, this guy just flat out roasted me. Sek is a confirmed savage, just like Atari Kobayashi from Isle of Dogs, like I said in the previous episode. He's 12, survived a fucking plane crash. And, like, survived like with a piece of plane metal in his head, but... yeah, minor spoilers. Yeah, I'm gonna try not completely spoil everything. Roach's Realm. Alliteration, just like some of the cool places where I in the forest in my backwoods, like Rusty Ridge. Actually, that's one of the only real places in my woods with real alliteration. There's other cool places like the Ratarch, or aka the Rooted Tree Arch, huh?
Is there some?
Oh,
yes.
Wow, you're gorgeous. You know, lends me out to close friends. Huh. Yeah, yeah. Don't you ever think of leaving? Your high horse is gonna save me. Please, man, you won't, like, want a sex like mom. Okay. You, Elwich.
I need another hit.
Huh, this is interesting. Watch, I've got a pouch of gold for someone that I need there. Gear. One that said it's for the gold. I barely got around for me alone, but any split I'll be making in this pouch will be coming right out of my pocket. Oh, come on, I'll be a little more generous since you'll meet around down here. As drunk as you meet down here. Since you've helped out a client, I'll spare a few coins. Don't spend a lot once. Thanks. Who are you?
Need something.
Durlid. Reminds me of someone like the Thieves Guild, like the Ragged Wagon Cistern. Something like that. Back out in Arma. And who knows, maybe we'll do some more Reach Exploring. You know what, one thing I hate? It's just when a person says bless you when you cough. That's just...
Something you need?
I don't think something like that can apply to... I don't think I'm saying bless you when you cough can do the same thing when you sneeze, you know? I don't know. It's just a little weird thing. Axiom's in. Huh, it's like the living quarters and... puddles and stuff everywhere here.
Yes?
Traveling merchant.
Need something?
Oh, she doesn't have anything for sale.
Make yourself busy.
On guard. You?
Something you need?
There's nothing here. No one's here, friend. Charred skeever meat. Goat legs. Horse meat. I'll take that horse meat. Along with these goat legs. Oops. Aww, in the water I go. Yeah. Move. Ah, there we go. I'm out of here. Let me look at my skills for a second. I gotta really increase my destruction skill. What could I do? I guess I could use rapids. But I don't really use rapids that much. Whirlwind, and rune, whirlwind. Oh yeah, I gotta get the ebony war axe too. Nice little one-hander. I'm gonna hit someone with that and they'll get knocked back. Like that. Yeah, this the wind and water magic is definitely two criminally underrated mods. Like, I just want a simple spell mod that just introduced only like a few spells and not something humongo like Lost Grimoire or Apocalypse Spell Package. But I might get either one depending on how it affects my performance. So yeah, Armor's Prison is coming for it as the Undertow. It is a horrifying reputation. Local law enforcement is more feared than respected. Kind of like the teachers at my school. They can be a little squirrely at times, but not that squirrely. Yeah, I think it's just because I once said yes, master, sarcastically to some guy. And granted, a few of them are lunkheads, but they're okay. Yeah, so my mom's actually a pretty good friend of mine. I kind of see this one teacher at my school as somewhat friends than teacher figures. Interesting. Yeah, there's one teacher. I'm not gonna say her real name just to protect her identity and whatnot. We actually have a lot of things in common. Oh, it's the Reach Merchant.
Cool. All right.
Yeah, me and her actually have a pretty. She actually likes to play Grand Theft Auto 4.
Something you need?
Ooh, I can buy a horse. Cool, I want a horse.
If you have the gold, sure thing. If not, then you'll have to get used to walking.
Use my offer.
Great. The horse is waiting for you at the back. Make sure to treat her well.
Okay.
Till next we meet.
Okay, this is my horse. Yeah, she actually likes she plays Grand Theft Auto 4, but not 5 actually, but that's fine. She also likes the Borderlands series, along with Left 4 Dead. Yeah, I don't really play that much Left 4 Dead anymore. Yeah, I mean, because I might do more Left 4 Dead videos, I just don't know when. I simply wasn't able to get into it that much. I wasn't able to fully integrate myself into the game-ish, game, I guess you could say. Should I go into horse or boat mode, into motor horse mode? I don't really have to swim that far. There we go. Uh-oh. Great. Hey! Get off of him! I am not losing my a horse that I just bought to some wolves. They're the one with the same blood as me and them, but... they need to be killed. Yeah, I just have to do it. Besides, those wolves probably have like this temper for all I know. Yeah? Horse? Horse. Where's my horse? Sorry, Nigo. Looks like we're gonna have to hoof it. Kingdom of Evermore. Yeah, we're also gonna go to the Hugrock Mines. Uh-oh. We got trouble ahead. Seriously! Oh, shit! Fireball! Okay, come on. one of the only main gripes that I have about Sky UI is what I wish they would add would be something like a for crafting menus. It would just simply show what was craftable and what wasn't. Like you could add, like there would be an option that would say show all craft or craftable. Like items that you had, like the required resources to craft. That way you wouldn't have to scroll through everything to find what you wanted to craft. Flamebinder. Okay, I think now calls for some sparks. Oh wait, no. Wait. Yeah. Uh-oh, I'm out of Magicka. Zap! Zap! Zap it time! Zappy epic zap time! I can't believe they killed my horse, too! Yeah! Seriously, I just bought this thing! I have a feeling like she'll respawn or whatever, but still. I'll have to wait like a few in-game days. Okay. Yeah, I guess despite some things that have been happening in my life, I sometimes I don't realize how good I have it. See, my parents, see, they're divorced. See. Usually, when a kid gets caught in the middle of a parent's divorce, they usually almost never see one of their parents again, like their mom or their dad, because either because of custody reasons or because they live too far away for them to see constantly. But things are different, and my parents didn't leave because they started hating each other. They simply just lost interest in each other. Their love simply just slowly dwindled away. They simply just lost interest in each other. And they left on good terms. They have controlled controlled custody is the right word for it. Like, that basically means that they're both allowed, my mom and dad are both allowed to see me, but I only live with my mom, though. Because my dad doesn't live in the house anymore. Only on a few occasions, he might, like, stay for, like, 1 or 2 days, but that's only in either emergencies, or some other reason. Or for something like a holiday. See, one of the scenarios that I can think about is, like, back during, like, the snowstorms back in, like, February, I think? Like, this was, like, a week when I was sick and stuff, so they needed a few other hands. Mom needed someone to help take care of me sometimes, and Dad usually takes care of me when Mom's not available. So... he's a nice man. 61... Yeah, my parents had me very late in their life. It took them a lot of work. Because, see, they had me when they were in their 40s. And, like, if you don't know, that's actually really hard because your body is all old and stuff. And it's pretty hard to have a baby when you're, like, 40-ish. Most people have, like, their baby when they're, like, their 20s or 30s, usually. Older sometimes. Things are fine. And also, this... me and my mom are gonna move, but see, we have a bit of choice. Mom says that we're just simply gonna move to another part of town, and my guess, this neighborhood that I'm in, my old neighborhood, will simply probably be in biking distance. I could probably just ride my bike back here and finally go back to my fort, and right now we're gonna explore these Hug Rock mines and, like, deal with these zombies, yeah. Wait, do I have it active? Let me see. Yeah, I have that from dust. Active it. Oh, that feels so good. A little bit. Let's pop them. Oh, I thought it was gonna be an enemy here. I don't know, enemy, the source of the necromancer. Is there a journal or something around here? But all of a sudden my character assumes that I got a necromancer. Oh yeah, I gotta click those fire salts for Idra. Who's Idra again? I can't remember. Tanning rack.
I am here.
here for you.
Can you talk to me, go?
If I am buried here under a big pile of dirt and rock, dig me out, please.
Nigo, Nigo, Nigo. You never cease to make me laugh, old friend. This weird necromancer man. Okay, let's crack open this door. It'd be kind of cool if I were to make a mod that somewhat overhauls the lockpicking system. Like, if you had a strong enough, like, one-handed skill, what you could do is you could do what's known as bashing the lock apart, but this would only have certain effects. Depending on your skill, you would either A, actually be able to break the lock and not have to use your lockpicks to open up the door. Or if your skill wasn't high enough, you would simply, the lock would actually be broken and like it, and it would actually be harder to open the door. Either that or to the point where you can't even open it. But that's only temporary. Like if you're like for something like a dungeon or something like a city, because like the guards would realize that someone had like the lock, that the lock was broken apart and they had to fix it. And if like someone actually sees you hitting the lock, you put a bounty on your head. Necromancer man. I'll shoot him. Henrig. Shoot it! Shoot it till it dies! Oh, and Henrig got the final blow! Oh, sorry I shot you there, Inigo. Oh no, I took a dead meme to the knee! Like, the meme has been dead for, like, almost over half a fucking decade. Ooh, experiment log. Ooh, cool. Take that. Let's take a look, see. Experiment log. What would be the best way to carry out the spell? I'm not sure others told me to conduct it on living persons. Probably a village or small settlement, so that we can see the results of the spell and send a warning for anyone that pursues us. Hitting two birds with one stone, I've settled a small hamlet called Sabat, where no one suspects a thing. This really is a first, because every other time I've tried something similar to this, some scoundrel always sniffs me out and goes hollering at the guard. The elder talks in an abandoned mind at the end of the scaffolding across this cliff deemed unsafe because of the shaky supports. This will be a good place to conduct my affairs. Alright, I've altered the spell slightly from the master's intent. I hope he doesn't mind. The spell now has a larger area of effect. Imagine being one of the first necromancers to make living test subjects essentially as mindless and obedient as those reanimated corpses. More motor functions, more complex tasks that they can perform. Maybe I'll get lucky and strike a couple women with it. Oh, great. Catastrophe! I don't know what to do! I can't return to the others. They'll tear me apart! The spell tore through the hamlet, searing the flesh of all that were in the way. I could hear screams for days from this mine. Fortunately, they were still obedient, but not anywhere near the sophistication we hoped. I left them at my flank. I hope I can mine enough ore from this mine to hopefully bribe one of these guards. I know many of them will only need a few septums to turn the other way. Okay, if I was a guard, I wouldn't accept the bribe, because, like, since he, like, killed, like, a bunch of people. Like there were, like, no amount of money would make me do that. Oh, shit. Great. Don't worry, Nigo, I'll protect you. Boom! Right in the wall. I hit the ceiling and they bumped down. Oh, right in the chest. Arrow to the chest. Oh! God damn it. Alright, we're good. Let's head out of Hugrock and quote unquote ask for a reward. I swear, if it's back in Onima. Okay, good. It's at the divide. So that's good. Yeah, I think we're at like maybe episode. Maybe sometime. after episode 50, we'll go back to the other game, go back to Falskar. But what I'm going to do is, I have a feeling the 50th episode will probably be something like an hour to hour and a half, or something like that. That's how long it would be. Yeah, you know what? I did this pretty okay-ish prank on April Fool's Day once. Like, this year, I mean. Like, what happened was, since it was Easter, I said that I put laxatives in the chocolate eggs some of the people were at the party were eating. And they just all looked at me, and I was like, ha! Just kidding, April Fools! Yeah, so I basically, like, double-tricked them. I tricked them into thinking that I tricked laced the eggs with laxatives. But I didn't actually, so double tricked. Yeah, pretty meta. I know. And this Beyond Reach thing kinda gives you a bit of hopelessness almost, you know? Very shit. The atmosphere is... The atmosphere... God damn, the atmosphere, man. It's crazy. Time to get to the divide. Hello, guardsman. Talk to Marosa as well as ask for a reward.
Hello?
Because even though I'm part dragon, I'm still hungry for money. Here we go. Divide Council Hall. Let's get this reward and as well as talk to Marosa soon. Hello. Ah, Marosa.
Oh, something you need.
Okay, why does she look a little weird? Anything in particular that I should? Jack has told me this evening that like the rumors were true.
He can very well bring our town down with his if he doesn't come to his senses. I'll have to make word with the council to see what can be done. Your deeds are appreciated. Make yourself feel welcome to Outreach. The head of the Imperial Ambassador, Drugger, needs someone as disciplined as you. Make sure to pay them a visit. Seems they're going to make a push against the Orsima who raised their outpost. Your help can make the difference. Till next we meet.
Interesting. Yeah, I think now might be a good time to, we won't really do much else with, I don't think we'll continue this Beyond Reach questline a little bit later. Like, we might finally go back to Skyrim and go with the finally finish Diplomatic Immunity. So, yeah. Let's go ask for a reward. Oh wait, no. I have to pick a lock, so I guess I'll wait. And then we'll just end the episode. There we go. Crashed. Well, I guess now's a good time to stop. I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.